Hello, spirits and lights. Thank you for coming back to Montana.
I am spirit. ASMR too. And I'm moving a little slow today. It's one of them days that I gotta rush to the room. You know, it's not like one of them really like exciting days. I thought that I'd be able to get up, but I'm feeling like them Monday blues or something. New study on my mic, so I don't know if it's gonna work out or not, but hopefully it does. And thank you to the spirit of light who sent me a message. So excited. She's so excited. I'm actually going with her to pick up her new lace. I told you guys she spent over $500 for it. I'm so proud of her. She saved her money and she got what she wanted. And you know, she said, "Mom, let me buy you a real wig." And I was like, at first I was like, and then I was like, no. Starting to ramble. Snapchat buddies yet. Yes. I'm just gonna brush on the mic a little bit. Thank you for sending me some nice Snapchats and saying hello. I love you guys. Yeah. Oh, and Abby, I don't know what's going on with your Snapchat, but I tried to return your call and I couldn't get through. I tried to text you, so I just want you to know that Spirit still love you, baby. I still love you. Yeah, so I don't know if something's going on with your Snapchat. Checking to see. I don't know. And hey, Kennedy. And hello to all my cute little Snapchappers. Yes. And yeah, hello, ASMR Queen. Hello. I know it's been a minute. Babies out there don't like water. Make sure you drink them water. It keep you hydrated and keep your skin beautiful. You may not think it's important right now, but when you get older, you're gonna wish you drank a lot of water. So drink plenty of water. Let's see. this is me today. I'm grabbing on, okay? I'm pushing through. Yes. I'm gonna use my MAC ProlongWear. I'm still squeezing the bottom. This is crazy. I'm just thinking to myself like I'm on camera putting dots on my freaking face, makeup and everything. Like, this is something you do in private. But I'm so glad that it don't bother me that I got the guts to do this. You know, a lot of people, they got so much to say. And, but, you know, I bet you they'll never do this. They'll never even try it. They want to real bad, but they just too scared. The camera come on, it freeze up. The camera don't scare me. It never did. I don't know why. I just ain't got the kind of personality. I'm not shy. Never been shy. Yeah, never been shy. But you know, sometimes being shy is kind of cute, you know? Especially a guy. Anxiety because my daughter start trying to figure out what she can do for me, be coming home trying to give me some crazy stuff. Like the last time she gave me that iron, it was black liquid. She like to kill me. Me and her was about to fight because she was like begging me to take this black liquor, and then when I took it, she gonna say, "Oh mom, it's not that bad. So, okay, you take it. You swallow the first swallow, and I swallow the next swallow." And she was like, "No, mom, just take it. It's not that bad. I'm telling you, not that bad to swallow." It went from me swallowing it to me her about to fight. Like, it was disgusting. It was black iron, liquid iron. And now she's sitting up there telling me, "Mom, we need to go to the store and get you some Terminex. You need to eat it." Why you got pimples all over the place, that not supposed to be sad about that or not, but I feel happy about it. Like, I was praying for myself this morning, and I said, Lord, let me see 50. Let me see 50. I want to be here. I do. I'm sorry. I'm so emotional. It's my anxiety. But I'm just so happy because, you know, like when they told me that I had to like maybe a good 5 years to live, you know, I was at one point just waiting for my 5 years to be over with so I could just die and be done with the suffering and the pain, you know. And then one day I decided to live. Like, I'm not gonna wait to die anymore, I'm gonna live. And then, you know, I started just everything I did was about a purpose of living, not a purpose of dying, you know. And you know, you get a certain age and you start getting depressed, like when you start turning 23 and 24. I'm getting old. You don't even know what old is. Stop it. Stop it. Shoot. You better be thinking, God, thank God you get to see 23 and 24 years old. I'm so happy. I'm gonna say this, I'm gonna see 50, and I'm so excited, you guys, because, you know, that's what I want to see 50, and I want to enjoy life. I want to enjoy every moment, and I want my life to be quality, and I want my life to mean something, you know. Hey, I want to get up and I want to do things that mean something. Like today, talking to you and being with you today means a lot to me, because, you know, this is important. You know, there's people out there that suffer worse than I do, that suffer less than I do, that are just lonely or just want to relax or just want to be calm or just feel like, you know, relatable. You know, if not relatable, maybe just like watching and just enjoying a moment of peace, you know. That's what I like to bring. I like to bring a moment of joy and peace and happiness to your life. That's important to me, you know. And I was thinking about, you know, when I see God, you know, what I'm going to say, what I'm going to do. I don't know. Oh, my God. You know, I just want God to just take me into his bosom, just hold me like a baby, like a newborn. And I just want to lay up, you know, all up in his shoulder, all up in his neck. And say, oh, my God, I'm home. And I want him to say, well done. Well done. You did well. You know, you can't please everybody. But you know what? The main person you got to please first is yourself. And if you please yourself and you're happy with who you are, then God is happy with you too. It don't matter what nobody else think. It really don't. Now, you know what I'm saying? If people can send out good energy and put that love towards you, but you're on that high energy, you know, that's good. Because it helps you keep moving on. I don't know if the reason why I'm up today and I'm breathing one more time is maybe because somebody prayed for me. Maybe somebody sent out good light for me. Maybe I deserve to be here. I don't know. But I know for sure that one day I'm gonna be gone. And I wanna look back on my life and be happy, you know? Some of the more cleaner, but I'm so scared that I'm gonna mess up my brush, and I pay so much for it, you know what I'm saying? Be paying $30 or more for a brush, and then hairs come out. Like, it's like, what the freak, what are you doing? Why you falling out? Get your ass back up there. Just kidding. But yeah, no, I gotta get me some brush cleaner. I like the Laura Mercier because it's darker, you know what I'm saying? Look at that, it's nice. You hear that new girl out there? She just a giggling. He got some new girl out there. He just met her over the weekend. Yeah, we're friends and stuff, you know. Oh, yeah, happy Martin Luther King Day to everybody. Today is Martin Luther King Day. Yeah, yes, okay. But, yeah, he met a girl over the weekend. She out there. Shut up. But, no, I can't say that because she don't know. She don't know. She dealing with the village. Oh, I don't know. She probably don't know. He was upset with his friend earlier. His friend was out there, and his friend was like, man, I don't understand why you're upset with me. He was like, I'm just saying, you know, back in my day, when you get in a fight, one of my friends get in a fight, you know, you're supposed to fight too, you know what I'm saying? And his friend was like, man, look, he probably met that guy in his apartment. How the freak you gonna be cheating on somebody and get yourself jumped in a spec for him to go over and get yourself jumped? Your ass get put out, then he get put out too. But his friend was like, man, I ain't trying to lie. I didn't know you called me. I didn't know you called me. He went on and on and on talking about, you know, once I told you they jumped me, you know, you should have been ready to go after them. You know, we should have did something. Do what? Your old hell. He, me and him around the same age, he might be older than me. His friend is definitely older than me. Talking about fighting some damn body. Talking about back in his day, him and his gang used to fight when someone wanted them get into a fight. You got kids over there talking about you want to fight somebody. And they got about three little girls. Make no sense. And you know the first man a female look up to is a daddy, you know what I'm saying? Moving shit. He bite all up in my face like, yeah, I'm not really, we did that, yeah. And then when she leave, he loud as hell. Yeah, she got an accent. She sound like she Mexican. She don't know, yo. She don't know. She don't know. He really talking soft. I can't believe it. She really giggling. testing dry up so quick. My kindness is Revlon. Dry too quick, but something, I don't know. Lord, this thing right here got me out of breath. Like I'm, I don't know, freaking out. use this Howley Illogical bronzer on my cheeks today. Say my goodbyes early because my camera be acting up on me lately. It wanna cut off. I'm thinking my brush wet. I had it here by my water. The ice, the coldness from the water got the brush damp. Thank you. little bit. That's trying to dry. I'm gonna put on one more coat. That's what I'm gonna do. Okay. finished look. This is it. I'm going out the door just like this. So I hope I look okay to you. Thank you so much for sitting through another video. Okay, I'm high. I gotta move there. I'm high because no spirit can't damn city. Instagram, bitch, before I go.
Hello, spirits and lights. Thank you for coming back to my channel.
I am spirit. It's a martyr. Yeah. so excited. She's so excited. I'm going, actually going with her to pick up her a new lace. I told you guys she spent over $500 for it. I'm so proud of her. She saved her money and she got what she wanted. And you know, she said, "Mom, let me buy you a real wig." And I was like, at first I was like, and then I was like, no. Let's see. She just a giggling. He got some new girl out there. He just met her over the weekend. She was over here with friends and stuff, you know. Oh, yeah. Happy Martin Luther King Day to everybody. Today is Martin Luther King Day. Yeah. Yes. Okay. But, yeah, he met a girl over the weekend. She out there. She don't know. She don't know. She dealing with the village hoes. I don't know. She probably don't know. He was upset with his friend earlier. His friend was out there. And his friend was like, "Man, I don't understand why you upset with me." He was like, "I'm just saying, you know, back in my day, when you get in a fight, one of my friends get in a fight, you know, you're supposed to fight too. You know what I'm saying?" And his friend was like, "Man, he probably met that guy in his apartment. How the freak you gonna be cheating on somebody and get yourself jumped and expect for him to come over here and get yourself jumped? Your ass get put out, then he get put out too." But his friend was like, "Man, I ain't trying to lie. I didn't know you called me. I didn't know you called me." He went on and on and on. Once I told you they jumped me, you know, you should have been ready to go after them. You know, we should have did something. Do what? Your old tell. He, me and him around the same age, he might be older than me. His friend is definitely older than me. Talking about fighting some damn body. Talking about back in his day, him and his gang used to fight when someone wanted them get into a fight. You got kids over there talking about you want to fight somebody. And they got about three little girls. Make no sense. And you know the first man a female look up to is a daddy, you know what I'm saying? yeah, she got an accent. She sound like she Mexican. She don't know, yo. She don't know. She don't know. Someone left me a comment and said, you need to get a freaking life. This is my life, honey. This is my freaking life right here. Okay, let's see. Thank you. testing dry out so quick. My kindness is Revlon. Dry too quick, but something, I don't know. But this thing right here got me out of breath. Like, I don't know, freaking out. this Holly Illogical bronzer on my cheeks today. Say my goodbyes early because my camera be acting up on me lately. It wanna cut off. I'm thinking my brush wet. I had it here by my water. The ice, the coldness from the water. Had a little baby saying, "Ola, ain't that cute? Ola." obviously. eggs in the bottom. Get an ear coming out. And thank you for all the comments. Yeah. Telling me that you like the way the makeup did match up to my face after it oxidized, and I appreciate you. I love you so much. This is crazy. I'm just thinking to myself, like, I'm on camera putting dots on my freaking face, makeup and everything. Like, this is something you do in private. But I'm so glad that it don't bother me that I got to do this. You know, a lot of people, they got so much to say. But, you know, I bet you they'll never do this. They'll never even try it. They want to real bad, but they're just too scared. The camera come on and freeze up. The camera don't scare me. It never did. I don't know why. I just ain't got the kind of personality. I'm not shy. I've never been shy. Yeah, I've never been shy. But, you know, sometimes being shy is kind of cute, you know. Especially a guy. But, I just ain't got it in me. She pushed through, you know, she pushes through. Okay, here I go. It's been a long weekend, you guys. Getting over my anxiety, it's been hard. And I hate when I get anxiety because my daughter starts trying to figure out what she can do for me, be coming home, trying to give me some crazy stuff. Like the last time she gave me that iron, it was black liquid. She like to kill me. Me and her was about to fight because she was like begging me to take this black liquor, and then when I took it, she gonna say, "Oh, mom, it's not that bad, it's not that bad." I said, "Okay, you take it. You swallow the first swallow, and I swallow the next swallow." And she was like, "No, mom, just take it. It's not that bad. I'm telling you, not that bad to swallow." It went from me swallowing it to me her about to bite. Like, it was disgusting. It was black iron, liquid iron. And now she's sitting up there telling me, "Mom, we need to go to the store and get you some Terminex. You need to eat it." Shut down. That's why you're not feeling good. And she's like, "Oh my God, what did you do?" gosh, you guys, I am so, like, I don't know, I'm feeling some type of way. I don't know why I'm feeling this way, but I am so happy that I'm going into, you know, one day I'm going to be 50 years old. I don't know if I'm supposed to be sad about that or not, but I feel happy about it. Like, I was praying for myself this morning, and I said, Lord, let me see 50. Let me see 50. I want to be here. I do. I'm sorry. I'm so emotional. It's my anxiety. But I'm just so happy because, you know, like, when they told me that I had to, like, maybe a good 5 years to live, you know, I was at one point just waiting for my 5 years to be over with so I could just die and be done with the suffering and the pain, you know. And then one day I decided to live. Like, I'm not gonna wait to die anymore, I'm gonna live. And then, you know, I started just everything I did was about a purpose of living, not a purpose of dying, you know. And you know, you get a certain age and you start getting depressed, like when you start turning 23 and 24. I'm getting old. You don't even know what old is. Stop it. Stop it. Shoot. You better be thanking God. Thank God you get to see 23 and 24 years old. I'm so happy. I'm gonna see 50. I'm gonna see 50, and I'm so excited. I'm so excited, you guys, because, you know, that's what I want. I wanna see 50, and I wanna enjoy life. I wanna enjoy every moment, and I want my life to be quality, and I want my life to mean something, you know. Hey, I wanna get up and I wanna do things that mean something. Like today, talking to you and being with you today means a lot to me, because, you know, this is important. You know, there's people out there that suffer worse than I do, that suffer less than I do, that are just lonely or just want to relax or just want to be calm or just feel like, you know, relatable. You know, if not relatable, maybe just like watching and just enjoying a moment of peace. You know, that's what I like to bring. I like to bring a moment of joy and peace and happiness to your life. That's important to me, you know. And I was thinking about, you know, when I see God, you know, what I'm gonna say, what I'm gonna do. I don't know. Oh my God, you know. I just want God to just take me into His bosom, just hold me like a baby, like a newborn. And I just want to lay up, you know, all up in His shoulder, all up in His neck. And say, oh my God, I'm home. And I want Him to say, well done. Well done. You did well. You know, you can't please everybody. But you know what? The main person you gotta please first is yourself. And if you please yourself and you happy with who you are, then God is happy with you too. It don't matter what nobody else think. It really don't. Now, you know what I'm saying? If people can send out good energy and put that love towards you, but you're on that high energy, you know, that's good. Because it helps you keep moving on. I don't know if the reason why I'm up today and I'm breathing one more time is maybe because somebody prayed for me. Maybe somebody sent out good light for me. Maybe I deserve to be here. I don't know. But I know for sure that one day I'm gonna be gone. And I want to look back on my life and be happy, you know. wash cleaner, but I'm so scared.